everybody. It's Brent here from EarthCruiser, and I'm hanging out right now out in the field prior to the Rocky Mountain Overland Rally. The show is going to be starting here in about 2 days. I got here a little bit early. I'm going to help Ray and Mario kind of set the field up and just kind of see how everything goes. So looking forward to the weekend, but on my way here from Bend, I was traveling and got the great opportunity to test out Garmin's new Overlander tablet. And because they were so kind to send me one for, or send EarthCruiser one for testing, I figured I would probably do them to do the due diligence of making a video. So the reason I'm in here at dark is mainly because I'm not a creeper, but if I'm going to show you the screen, I want to make sure that it comes across as best as it can, and at night it will not be disrupted from the reflection of the windows inside the EarthCruiser off of the off of the screen and the camera. So, excuse me. But the other nice thing though is that I will say when I was driving, the screen was very bright. I could easily see the GPS. It's sitting, you know, just behind the steering wheel, kind of on the dash, and it was very visible, and I had no problems with it at all. So, all right, so I'm going to go over and just kind of turn this puppy on so you guys can kind of see it here. So it brings up this, obviously, the screen that kind of, you just press agree, and you kind of get into the main screen here of the Overlander. The two main areas that you're going to see is the drive as well as the explore. The drive, what it brings up, if I select it here, is going to be your normal navigation that you would typically find on a Garmin device. Okay, it's going to be your turn by turn type navigation. If I press the back button right here and go into the other screen, what this brings up is what most of us are going to be used to when we travel off road. Excuse me. The screen that I'm on here is pretty much Garmin's new Explorer software that is built into the device. The nice thing about this is that it seamlessly integrates with the web version of this. So if you have an Explorer account and you're making waypoints and doing a bunch of things like that, you can make sure that anything that you upload into that Express software on your computer, desktop, laptop, whatever you decide to use, even like your mobile app, once this tablet hits Wi-Fi and connects to the internet, it's automatically going to sync to those things, which I think is a really slick thing that that Garmin did. The other thing that I really like about it, one of my favorite features, was that as I'm doing my turn-by-turn driving, this little icon up in the upper right-hand corner will actually take me directly to where I'm at on the Garmin Explorer map. So I can quickly just go back and forth again from my turn-by-turn back into the Explorer app. So I really like that feature. Mainly it's because I still like to use turn-by-turn, program things in. Garmin probably has the best turn-by-turn navigator out there. Google Maps, I gotcha, you're really good. Garmin's just been doing it for very long, and they have some really slick features like bringing up a picture of the turn and the route that you're supposed to go and which lane you're supposed to be in. I mean, how can you beat that when you're on a rushed highway in a busy city and you're like, what lane do I get in? Now you know. Like, Garmin does a really good job with that. So, I really like Garmin's turn-by-turn, but then when I go off-road or I just want to check out areas around me, I can then jump into the Explorer app and see maybe what is that dirt road that's off there, because the Explorer app's going to have pre-programmed in a lot of the backcountry roads. I mean, this is the Delorean mapping that is built into this software. So you'll find BLM roads, National Forest Service, all kinds of stuff already pre-programmed and built into the Express app, which is nice. The other nice thing I like about the Express app is while you're in it, let's say you're traveling along and you're like, ooh, that would be a really nice campsite over here by this creek. you just tap and hold like you normally would, and you can add a waypoint. And then you can tag that waypoint, you can add notes, and you can put a little icon on it based off of what you want it to be. So if I go in here and I can start collections, obviously I have some pre-programmed collections in here already, but I could add it to a folder. I could go back and it's having me name collections now. But I could go back. This little guy right here is your back button. So I can just keep pressing him and go back. But I could go in here too and click on the little map to take me back to
drive to highlighted route.
Exactly. It will give me directions, like a turn by turn direction to that highlighted route, which is pretty slick. And then there's just a bunch of things that you can, I'm going to stop this. There's a bunch of things that you can get into when you set that waypoint, and you can categorize it, and it will automatically sync into your Express software, whether you're on your laptop, your cell phone, all the stuff that it syncs into. So a couple other cool features about the Garmin is if I program in, let's say, a location. So if I go into drive, actually, let me go into where to, and I just type in, let's say, recent. So it's going to take me to here. If I go into Trader Joe's, right? So it's going to think a little bit. It's going to give me...
Please drive to highlighted route.
The highlighted route that's here. Now, let's say that on my route, I kind of want to change things up a little bit. Or I want to add something to that route. If I click this little icon right here, and I say... buttons, and I go up to edit route, I can say, I am messing up here, guys, sorry about that. I can detour, I can add different things to it, or I could say, hey Garmin, find place.
Speak the name of a place.
Starbucks.
Searching for Starbucks. Select a line number. Would you like to begin navigation? Start new route or add as next stop.
So that's a really...
Please drive to highlighted route.
There we go. So that's a really cool feature because now I can add stops along my route without having to change my entire directional map that I just had Garmin put together. I really like that. It's simple. I can't figure that out with Google Maps yet. Maybe I'm just not brilliant enough. But anyways, I think Garmin makes it pretty simple in order to do that. So that is one feature that I liked while I was driving and using this, is that I needed to find gas, or I wanted to get a cup of coffee, or I just had to go to the restroom and let my dog out or do whatever else. So I was easily able to just say that, get it into the device, and then automatically add that stop to my route, which is what I thought was pretty slick. The next cool feature that I want to show you guys is they do have a pitch and roll feature on here. Yes, I know it's, kind of cheesy for those off-roaders or people who, kind of say that they don't need these things or whatever. And let's say my device was tilted differently. When you press this calibrate button, it automatically finds the level of how the device is sitting in your vehicle, and then that creates 0 degrees. Also, I can go into settings, and I can pre-program some of these so that when I turn it, I'm going to pop this off real quick. But when I turn it, you see how it turns red? That means that it's to the limit that I set in here. So it's kind of neat that it has those features. This is the back button right here. This takes you back to home, which is what I'm already on. The next thing that it will do that I liked was the ABC. I thought this was a really cool feature. And what this is, altimeter, barometer, compass. can't get more simple than that. It was really neat how I could just go back and forth and see exactly how much altitude I was at, exactly how much vert that I ended up climbing that day on that, when I was tracking. And then campgrounds, I think, is pretty neat. They have pre-programmed campgrounds in here, but better yet, they have programmed in iOverlander stuff. That is huge. So iOverlander, actually, they have them pre-programmed in, loaded on the device, so that you can find up-to-date iOverlander campsites right through the Garmin Overlander, which I think is just a great feature. Finally, last but not least, is the connection with InReach. So I have my little InReach device right here, and if I go in here, and it will Bluetooth to the InReach, basically lets me put my messages up there. I can send everything out, it Bluetooths right to it, so that my off-road communication is now linked with my Garmin Navigator, and it's just a really slick feature. So anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed my overview of the app, or of the Garmin Overlander. If there's other things that you want to know, leave comments, but subscribe to our channel. We got some really cool videos coming up, and I'm glad you guys took the time to listen to this today. So thanks again, and keep traveling.